All right, so this is a suggestion via The Nation. The name of the song is Beautiful by the artist Eminem. Listen, if you are new here, please like and subscribe. The more that you like this content, the more that I know that you specifically would like to see more of this specific type of content, okay? Let's go ahead and just jump into this immediately. We have the lyrics pulled up to the left just in case we need them, all right? Let's jump into it, guys.
To reach, I've been too long on my own. Everybody has a private world where they can be alone. Are you calling me? Are you trying to get through? Are you reaching out for me? I'm reaching out for you.
I'm just so fucking depressed, I just can't seem to get out this slump. If I could just get over this hump, but I need something to pull me out this dump. I took my bruises, took my lumps, fell down and I got right back up. But
wait a second, was this song itself released during his addiction? Let me know in the comments. I also think that this song may be popular for one main reason. He starts up by saying that he's so depressed, right? And I just can't seem to get out of this slump, right? I think that that in itself can attract so many people to the song, right? Because everyone, in a sense, goes through some form, of depression itself. This kid, they can identify with this easily, guys. Right? Let's continue.
Gonna pull me out this dump. I took my bruises, took my lumps, fell down, and I got right back up. But I need that spark to get psyched back up in order for me to pick the mic back up. I don't know how or why or when I ended up in this position I'm in. I'm starting to feel distant again, so I decided just to pick this pen up and try to make an attempt to vent, but I just can't admit or come to grips with the fact that I may be done with rap. I need a new outlet, and I know some shit's so hard to swallow. But
wait, I think, I don't know if, let me know in the comments also, guys. I think that how he's writing this song, like based off of the stats in the beginning of the song, right? Referring to Michigan and basically Detroit itself, right? Yeah, Detroit was definitely a superpower, literally, right? And it fell. It just did, right? Unfortunately. So I think that maybe this song itself is being written from the perspective of, like, if Detroit could make a song, right? It feels like it, at least, right? Because just purely based on the stats and the imagery that's being shown currently. Right? Let's continue.
I just can't sit back and wallow in my own sorrow, but I know one fact, I'll be one tough fact to follow. One tough fact to follow, I'll be one tough fact to follow. Here today, gone tomorrow, but you have to walk 1,000 miles. In my shoes, just to see what it's like to be me. I'll be you, next straight shoes, just to see what it'd be like to feel your pain, feel mine. Go inside each other's minds, just to see what we find. Look at shit through each other's eyes, but don't let them say you. Everything's so tense and gloom, I almost feel like I gotta check the temperature of the room. Just as soon as I walk in, it's like all eyes on me, so I try to avoid any eye contact, cause if I do that, then it opens the door for conversation like I want that. I'm not looking for extra attention, I just wanna be just like you, blend in with the rest of the room, maybe just point me to the closest restroom. I don't need no fucking manservant trying to follow me around and wipe my ass, laugh at every single joke I crack, and half of them ain't even funny like that. Marshall, you're so funny, man. You should be a comedian, goddamn. Unfortunately, I am. I just hide behind the tears of a clown. Ooh. So why don't you all sit down? Listen to the tale I'm about to tell. Hell, we don't gotta trade our shoes, and you ain't gotta walk no 1,000 miles. In my shoes, just to see what.
Yeah, this song just feels honest. He's just being honest with himself, his fans, and overall his critics, right? He's just telling, listen, this is exactly who I am. These are some of the issues that I go through on a regular basis. And no matter what you may say or anyone says, you're still beautiful. I like the whole concept of that, guys. It's strong messaging.
I
what it's like. Absolutely strong messaging.
Take these cards ourselves and flip them, don't expect no help. Now I could have either just sat on my ass and pissed and moaned, or take the situation in which I'm placed in and get up and keep my own. I was never the type of kid to
exactly, bro. Use the pain in your life to help you succeed. Factual.
In which I'm placed
respect,
in and get up and
respect,
keep my
respect,
own.
Bro.
I was never the type of kid to wait by the door and pack his bags and sat on the porch and hoped and prayed for a dad to show up who never did. I just wanted to fit in every single place, every school I went. I dreamed of being that cool kid, even if it meant acting stupid. And Edna always told me, keep making that face and it gets stuck like that. Meanwhile, I'm just standing there holding my tongue, trying to talk like...
I think every like... mother in like the 90s would say that. Don't make these funny faces, right? Your face is gonna get stuck like that, bro. Right? Let me know in the comments if one of your parents or one of your family members have told you that, bro. It can't just be me. I promise you, it can't just be me, guys.
Till I suck my tongue on that frozen stop sign pole at 8 years old. I learned my lesson then, cause I wasn't trying to impress my friends no more. But I already told you my whole life story, not just based on my description. Cause where you see it from where you're sitting is probably 110% different. I guess we would have to walk a mile in each other's shoes at least. What size you wear?
More than a mile, bro.
Let's see if you can fit your feet. My shoes, just to see what it's like to be me. I'll be you, like straight shoes, just to see what it'd be like to. Your pain, you feel mine, go inside each other's minds, just to see what we find. Look at shit through each other's eyes, but don't let them say you ain't beautiful. They can all get.
That's like one of the dopest lines in the song right now, guys. Listen. This whole song is about him, right? It's about him, and then also it feels like a double. I don't know. I can't explain it, guys. It feels like this is also about the state of Michigan, right? You know, because, as I said, top of the world, then now the bottom of the world. You get what I'm saying? So it just feels like the state may be in a depressive state, or potentially even the city itself, Detroit, right? All right, guys, listen. The strongest line of the song for me personally, the one that hits me the hardest, is don't ever let anyone say you're not beautiful, right? I love the concept of it. Literally scream that from the top of the buildings, bro. For real. It's crazy. Yeah, some people will say, yeah, it's corny, right? But like, I don't think those people are being honest with themselves. I'm be honest, right? Guys, this is a strong song, and I think this is probably one of his strongest and more meaningful songs, right? You know, listen, don't get me wrong, I absolutely love, you know, the Eminem where we just sit there literally and break down bars for like about 30 minutes, right? I love the concept of that, right? But guys, there's something different about when he does songs like this, like message heavy songs, like change the world type of songs, right? I love that type of content from him, guys. Listen, let me know in the comments of the next thing I should be listening to from him, and I'll get into that as soon as I possibly can. All right, then listen, you guys all have an amazing day and enjoy it thoroughly. All right.